Hello to everyone, guys. Vladimir Rulad, aka the Bulgarian God, we're speaking. And today, I decided to talk a bit more on scheduled bouts and so on. And Priscilla Cachara, you know, this girl has always fascinated me because of her fabulous will to survive, to fight, and to go until the last dying breath. And this is something that pretty much intrigues me a lot when it comes to her. And, you know, especially that battering and bashing she received from Valentina Shevchenko. Now, you know that Priscilla Cachara accepted to replace Rachel Ostovich to face Shana Dobson at UFC Oakland. And you know that UFC Oakland is taking place on February 22nd. So it's kind of fighting on short notice, you know, especially for Cachara. You know, I'm kind of shocked because she accepted it on a 3 weeks notice. And now this is, well, these fighters are not much famous, but I'm intrigued by both of them because growing up with a problematic childhood and such things, you know, it can destroy the man on the other side, or it can make you a fighter. It can make you one of the best fighters in the world, one of the most dominant fighters in the world, the guy who never surrenders. And that's Priscilla Cachara, definitely. This girl has never surrendered. She kept progressing. She was always fighting until the last dying breath. And yeah, that's the reason why I started live and watching her. You know, she was riding a perfect score of 8-0, you know, because the Brazilian promotions, which are not easy to, you know, Brazilian promotions are everything but easy. There are so many strong mixed martial artists in Brazilian promotions. And she scored 4 decision wins, 4 TKOs and KOs, finishes. So you can't call her a real finisher, you know. I'd call her a tactician. That's how I'd call her. You know, in the first match against Valentina Shevchenko, we actually saw nothing because she landed only 3 strikes. Comparing to Valentina's 230, it was a very, very big, big difference. But in the second fight, we saw better versions. You know, she lost the unanimous decision to Molly McCann and Luana Carolina, but she fought fine. You know, she fought well. I was kind of happy with what I saw. Shayna Danger Dobson, you know, she won TUF 26 finale against Ariel Beck. And previously to that, she lost to Nico Montano, which is kind of not a shame. You know, Nico Montano is a good opponent. Lauren Miller, Sabina Mazu decisioned her. So, yeah, but she has strong strikes, you know. You don't call someone Danger for no reason. And this girl, she is just tough. She is just very, very tough. On the other side, looking back at Priscilla Cachara, you know, it's tough to think because she goes forward. She is a tactician who goes forward, goes backward. Since her bout against Valentina Shevchenko, I've seen many, many improvements in her game. Looking back at this, it takes place at Oakland, which maybe isn't the best soil for Priscilla Cachara on one end. On the other end, Shana Dobson is also in the situation must win or lose UFC contract and get released. So this is be or not to be for both fighters. Shana Dobson is great in stand-up, but Priscilla Cachara lost via submission only once. Looking back at Shana Danger Dobson, well, she has never been finished except of in her amateur fight against Roxanne Modafferi. So it's something that actually worries me, you know. Priscilla Cachara, I doubt she can finish her. I mean, she's a different fighter now. She's a very smart fighter now. I expect 3 tactical rounds. I expect 3 very, very much intriguing match, very much a game of chess. That's what I'm expecting. I'd like to give Priscilla more chances for a victory, but unfortunately, there is one problem. Priscilla is tough, but she simply can't turn the lights out yet because these girls are very, very strong. And she's a cardio machine, but she's not a super powerful puncher. So I expect 3 rounds. I expect 3 rounds of war. I expect a decision fight, and we'll see who's going to win. I think Shana has maybe 51-52%. That's what I'm getting. But if Priscilla can win, if the fight doesn't go to the ground, and I hope she will stop the takedowns. But looking back at her match with Valentina, her takedown defense was terrible. But in the last 2 matches, she showed pretty much solid takedown defense. So I believe she worked on it. I'd like her to keep the contract and to be one of the greatest Brazilian fighters, because, you know, she's been through hell and she deserves another shot. And I, from the bottom of my heart, I hope it's going to be Priscilla, but I give slightly more chances to Shannah Dobson.